Hi, my name is Gabriel. In this video, I will teach you everything you need to get started with GoodNotes. Let's create our first notebook by tapping on the plus button in the upper left. If you want to use another paper template or cover, just tap on one of the thumbnails. Don't worry, you will still be able to change the template later. For now, I will continue with a plain paper. Alright, let's choose a name for our first notebook. I will simply call it Notes. Here we go. To go to the next page, swipe left with two fingers. If you use an Apple Pencil, you can do it with one finger. Above the page, you can see the toolbar. Select one of the tools in the middle by tapping on it. The pen is already selected here. Now you can write your first words with your finger or a stylus. Here we go. Now let's highlight the words we have just written, not in yellow, but in green instead. To change the colors, tap on the selected tool again. Here we go. The pen, the highlighter, the eraser, and the lasso tool all have additional settings which you can try out later. Now let's select the lasso tool. It is a really powerful and very helpful tool because it lets you reorder things on the page, change the color of your handwriting, resize objects, or convert handwritten words to typed text. Draw a circle around something and tap inside of the selection to bring up the lasso tool menu. Let's resize this. That's large enough. Tap outside of the selection to deselect it. Great! Now we already know how to use the basic tools. Let's create a new page by simply swiping to the left with two fingers. Pull and release. There are a couple of modes that are really helpful. Use the read-only mode if you want to read through your notebooks comfortably. It will disable all other finger input and lets you navigate between the pages easily with one finger. To deactivate it, tap on one of the other tools. The shape recognition mode lets you draw perfect shapes like circles, lines, or rectangles. Don't forget to deactivate it once you're done drawing shapes by tapping on it again. The zoom window magnifies a part of the page, which is indicated by a small blue area. You can write in large letters in the new window at the bottom, and it will appear in the according ratio on the page. Once you have crossed the middle of the zoom window, a small blue area will appear on the left side. It is corresponding to the blue area which you can see on the page. Continue writing in there, and the zoom window will automatically move forward, which allows a smooth writing experience. I can disable the zoom window by tapping on the icon again. More options can be accessed by tapping on the three small dots in the upper right of the toolbar. Here you can search for your handwriting or export your pages to send an email or to upload them to a cloud storage or another app. Opening the thumbnail view gives you an overview of all the pages inside of your notebook. Here you can reorder pages, or delete, copy, export, or rotate them by tapping Edit. Now let's go back to the library by tapping the Back button. Remember how we created our first notebook? The plus button doesn't only let you do this, but also lets you import PDF, Word, or PowerPoint documents. Tap Import and select the source. Choose your document, and it will appear in your library. You can now use all the tools that I already explained you in this video. That's it for now. If you have more questions, check out our user guide or our FAQ, which are linked below this video.